Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahal Engineering College, Kovilvindi. I am happy to meet you again through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is module 5. We are discussing on radiation heat transfer. Today it is lecture number 11, and we are going to solve problem, additional problem in the radiation between three surface enclosure. And we solved the problem in the previous lecture also, we solved the problem. So at the end of this lecture, you will solve problem on three surface enclosure of the re-radiating surface on your own. And this is example number 29 from an university examination question paper, May 2011. Two parallel plates 1 meter by 1 meter are spaced 2 meter apart. The plates are at a temperature of 727 degrees Celsius and 227 degrees Celsius, and their emissivity are 0.3 and 0.5 respectively. The plates are located in a large room, the wall of which are at a 27 degrees Celsius. Determine the rate of heat loss from each plate and the heat gained by the walls. And the given data, which is 2 meter, plate size is 2 meter by 1 meter and distance equal to 2 meter. T1 equal to 1000 Kelvin, T2 equal to 500 Kelvin, T3 equal to 300 Kelvin, epsilon 1 equal to 0.3 and epsilon 2 equal to 0.5. And this is the arrangement, the top plate and the bottom plate, and they are top plate, the size of the plate is 2 meter by 1 meter and the space between the plate is 2 meter, and the top surface is at 1000 Kelvin and the emissivity 0.3, and the bottom surface at temperature 500 Kelvin and the emissivity 0.5, and you have the third surface atmosphere side walls which are at a temperature 300 Kelvin and they are re-radiating. Now we draw the network. So the first surface EB1, MEC power EB1 and radiosity J1, in between we have the resistance R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 by A1 epsilon 1, and the second surface is EB2 of surface resistance R2 equal to 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 epsilon 2 and radiosity J2, and the third surface is the room with the MEC power EB3 which is equal to J3, and R12 is the shape factor resistance between J1 and J2, R13 is the shape factor resistance between J1 and J3, and R23 is the shape factor resistance between J2 and J3. The value of the surface resistances, so the area equal to 2 meter by 1 meter, R1 equal to 1 minus epsilon 1 divided by A1 epsilon 1, which is 1 minus 0.3 divided by 2 into 0.3 equal to 1.67, and R2 equal to 1 minus epsilon 2 divided by A2 epsilon 2, which is 1 minus 0.5 divided by 2 into 0.5 equal to 0.5. And this is the arrangement, area of the surface or 2 meter square, shape factor between surface 1 and 2, 2 meter B equal to 2 meter, A equal to 1 meter, and C equal to 2 meter, and calculating the X value, which is B by C equal to 2 meter by 2 meter equal to 1, and Y value A by C, which is 1 by 2. So A equal to 1 meter, B, C equal to 2 meter, 0.5. Now X equal to 1, Y equal to 0.5, and in the X axis, we have the B by C X value, and this is 1. And in the curve for different values of A by C, which is 0.5. So this is value of the curve, value of the shape factor between 1 and 2, F12 equal to 0.116. So from the graph, you can find out are the same data is given in the form of a table on the adjacent page in your design heat and mass transfer data book. You can refer to it and find out the shape factor, which is 0.116. So from the summation rule, F12 plus F13 equal to 1. So here F13 equal to 1 minus F12, which is 1 minus 0.116 equal to 0.884. And the F13 is also equal to F23, which is 0.884. Now calculating the shape factor resistances, R12 equal to 1 by A1 F12, which is 1 by 2 into 0.116, 0.116 equal to 4.31, and R13 equal to R23 equal to 1 by A1 F13, which is 1 by 2 into 0.884 equal to 0.565. And calculating the emissivities, EB1 equal to sigma into T1 to the power 4, which is 56,700 watts per meter square. EBT equal to 5.67 10 power minus 8 into 500 to the power 4, which is 3543.75 watts per meter square. EB3 equal to sigma into T3 to the power 4, which is 5.67 10 power minus 8, 300 to the power 4, which is 459.27 watts per meter square. And using the Kirchhoff's equation, substituting the equation for the Kirchhoff's equation for the node 1, J1, EB1 minus J1 divided by R1 plus J2 minus J1 divided by R12 plus J3 minus J1 divided by R13 equal to 0. And substituting all the values, 56700 minus J1 divided by 1.67 plus J2 minus J1 divided by 4.31 plus 459.27 minus J1 divided by 0.565 equal to 0. Mathematically simplifying, this is 0.943 J2 minus 25.675 J1. Equal to minus of 3.39 10 power 5. Similarly, for the nodal equation 2, for node 2, EB2 minus J2 by R2 plus J1 minus J2 divided by R12 plus J3 minus J2 divided by R23 equal to 0. For J3 equal to EB3, so this is 3543.75 minus J2 divided by 0.5 plus J1 minus J2 divided by 4.31 plus 459.27 minus J2 divided by 5.5675. And they simplify the equation. This will be 0.285 into J1 minus 4.87 to J2. This is equal to minus of 9618.72. And these are the two equations, first equation, second equation. So solving the two equations. So the first equation is multiplied by 4.872. The second equation is multiplied by 0.943. So this will be adding the two equations, it will cancel the J2 value. So I will get minus of 124.831 J1 equal to minus of 1.6 in 10 power 6. So J1 equal to 13,298. And substituting in the first equation and J2 equal to 2000. So you can listen to the calculation for a moment and you can understand simple arithmetic calculation solving two algebraic equation to find the values of J1 and J2. Okay. Then J1 equal to 13,298 watts per meter square, J2 equal to 2000 watts per meter square, and the amount of heat transfer between the plate 1 and 2, Q12 equal to J1 minus J2 divided by R12 equal to 13,298 minus 2000 divided by 4.31. Which is 2621.3 watts, and the heat leaving the surface 1, Q1 equal to EB1 minus J1 divided by R1, 56700 minus 13298 divided by 1.67 equal to 25899.2, and the heat leaving the surface 2, Q2 equal to EB2 minus J2 divided by R2, which is 3543.75 minus 2000 divided by 0.5 equal to 3087.5 watts. And the heat absorbed by the room, we have this equation Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 equal to 0. And this Q3 equal to minus of Q2 minus Q1 is equal to minus 3087.5 minus 25982.2 is equal to minus of 29610.7 watts. So these are the books I referred for the subject. You can refer to it. And this is the book published by me. You can reach to the book for additional problems. And you can write to me for any queries or clarification. I will clarify your doubt. And thank you. We'll meet the next lecture. We take a few more problems on the same topic. Thank you.